Well, it's not quite a tsunami, but that fierce easterly is pushing those waves into Papamoa Beach here. You're between Mortiti and Taylor Reserve, I think, one of the many access points onto the beach. Graham, we're talking about tsunami, and what's a tsunami and what causes them?
Andrew, tsunami are any disturbance of the ocean or a lake that isn't normal. They're usually caused by the bottom of the lake or the bed of the ocean getting pushed up or pulled down, and the most common way for that to happen is in an earthquake. So in an earthquake where a fault line ruptures and you push the seabed up and the water above it immediately moves up as well. And all a tsunami is that water leveling itself back out. And it has to level itself back out over the whole ocean.
Yeah.
So everywhere in the Pacific Ocean is susceptible to tsunami. All of New Zealand's coastline is susceptible to tsunami. The earthquakes come from fault lines all the way around the edge of the Pacific Ring of Fire.
Yeah.
It's associated with volcanoes, but it's also associated with fault lines and earthquakes and tsunami. So New Zealand can get tsunami from all different distances. And we talk about distant sources being South America, North America, right up through Japan. They're up to 12 or more hours travel time away. We talk about regional sources like the Pacific Islands, Samoa, Vanuatu. They're in the order of 1 to 3 hours of travel time away. And then we've got local sources, which are the faults just offshore of New Zealand, less than an hour of travel time away. And those are the ones where that long or strong get gone message is so important. We've got official warnings for the farther sources away than that with emergency mobile alerts, but it's those local ones that are attached to the earthquake you feel.
And so what sort of impacts can we expect from either of those local, distant or regional tsunami?
So all tsunami behave the same, it's just the ones from closer by tend to be bigger.
Yeah.
They're not like an ocean wave, they're not like a wind wave when the wind's pushing the surf like you're seeing today behind me. We're talking about a surge of water that keeps coming for minutes and tens of minutes, maybe even 20 or 30 minutes, and then it'll rush back out for 20 or 30 minutes, and it can keep doing that for many, many hours. That's why it's really important to stay evacuated until you get the official all clear, because the first wave may not be the biggest.
Right. So you've got the long or strong get gone, so if you feel an earthquake and if it's long and it's strong, but how else do we know that there is might be a tsunami on its way?
So tsunami science has come a long way in the last decade or two. We've got great bits of technology like deep ocean buoys far out in the ocean that actually weigh the water column out there and tell us if a tsunami's passed over them to give us early warning. We now have emergency mobile alerts reaching almost everyone's cell phone within minutes. So the technology and our ability to detect has come a long way, but it's still the earthquake that we're detecting at the start. So if you do feel that long or strong earthquake, longer than a minute or hard to stand up, that is the fastest warning you might get, and it might be the only warning you get. So you have to evacuate immediately.
Okay.
Don't wait for anything, get gone.
Good one. Hey, thanks, Graham.